say the connection is weak from Facebook Live. I might have to go all the way from the data. Come on in the room. Hey, everybody on Facebook and, what is this? Hey, hon, how are you? Happy Monday, as always. Happy Monday, everybody. We are doing it a tad bit earlier than we normally do, but that's more of a trying to get done, give ourselves a little bit more extra time this time. So give everybody time to get in room. Hey, Jay, Nicole, how are you? We miss you, too. What you been up to? Mr. Thomas getting him something to drink. Oh, he got me something to drink, too. You might be all right. I might keep him another day. Right. One more day. Hey, Sailor. Babe, we done got the celebrity Mr. Sailor on here. Baltimore loves you guys. Well, thank you, Jeff White, for Baltimore. Y'all know I'm talking back and forth to Facebook Live and Instagram Live. And so I am trying to get everybody a moment to get on there. I think I'm going to have to turn off of the Wi-Fi for Facebook Live. That's what it's doing. So anyway, it's here. Tablet right here. What's
do I need to get my phone?
No, your phone ain't charged, black person. So anyway, so I would appreciate you guys if you have a moment to in the left hand corner on Facebook to share it to your page to get people to join so they can join us while we're actually on the broadcast. So again, shout out who you are and where you're from. Give everybody time to get everybody, but we could push just the camera. I don't know how to fix that. Both of them in there. So give everybody, I think I'm going to go over a little bit. What you think?
That's good.
You cut off half the way.
You cut off half the way on that one too.
I know, right? What are we doing?
That's the problem. You doing it.
Ah! Did you say I'm doing it?
Mm-hmm. This one here? This is mine?
Sailor, say what's up?
Hey, what's going on, man?
Why you taking my pen?
This mine or this one?
It don't matter, baby. I'm reading off here, so it don't matter. So tell us where you, who you are and where you're from and share to your page. I appreciate it. So give us a minute, give everybody a minute to get in the room because every time we start, people say, well, come in and say, what's the topic and what did I miss? So trying to give everybody a chance to get in. Ivory from Mississippi. All right. That man can read.
Right.
He looking like he retarded. You seen him?
Prohibit me. From,
he is special.
Doing my notes and everything like that.
I don't know what you're taking notes for. I don't know what, but I see you with the beat. Girl, please. Ain't no beat. I've been in bed. Today was a day off, and I had to do something because my husband was looking hurt. That wasn't nice, though. I thought he loved me, but he might not.
I can play cousin. What's up, Edward?
Clark.
I'm in the house.
Clark's from Savannah. Jennifer from Brooklyn, New York. All right. Hey, Jennifer.
Brooklyn.
Edward from Alabama. I see y'all. Y'all coming on in. Again, on the left-hand side, if you're on Facebook, you can share to your page so people can join us and give everybody time to get in the room so we won't get started and then they come in a little bit later. I thought, this might get my nerves.
Can't you do the on this thing sideways?
It was acting up. Look, Jay and Nicole told me y'all got a backdrop. Shucks, not big time. Fade to black. Black Love World Tour. Don't start that dumb stuff again.
World Tour, baby.
This is actually our backdrop for
the Christmas gala.
Our Christmas gala. Oh, all our events.
The red carpet.
But I was trying. Okay, so she says she can't hear. Let me see what we got going on. I don't know why you can't hear. Oh, you know what? You should hit your phone because I don't know if Open Mic has to block out. Okay, she says she can now. So. But I was trying to do something different because the couch is always kind of weird and uncomfortable for us. So I was trying to see if we can find something else to do that would be a little bit better. Hey, Mildred, how are you? So, so T-Bear says she couldn't hear on Instagram Live, but she can hear now. We're trying to get all technical issues out of the way and all that good stuff.
Right.
So
we upgrading our situation.
Well, we're not yet. We trying. We working on it. Princess says hi.
Yeah, we working on our little makeshift studio.
Is that Donna? Okay, hey, Donna. That's the idea. See, it won't let me do the button. It won't let me match the button.
No.
So, again, if you just joined us, tell us where you're from. And your name and where you're from. I know most people have that's already here have told us already. Hey, Miss Donna, how are you? Tonight is a very serious / deep / good conversation.
Are you going deep?
Really? I'm trying to find my hairpin, but it ain't working.
Who's that saying about? You see, we got t-shirts on too. You checking us out, right?
What is that? What are you talking about? Honey?
Somebody says about the backdrop.
That was an hour ago. You so late.
You said an hour ago.
I'm saying, but you just come in now with the backdrop.
Girl.
Anyway, okay, so did we have a good Valentine's? Ask us what we ate for Valentine's.
Huh?
What we do for Valentine's?
KFC.
I told y'all we don't do Valentine's, so we were.
She did have a good Valentine's. I got her a gift bag, and she was still hating.
I know.
Yes, she was. Y'all need to rebuke her.
I put it on the page. I did put that he surprised me with a little gift, because we don't do gifts.
She didn't want to give me credit, my credit.
I did give her. Uh-oh, him. My daughter walked in the kitchen, threw me off. I did give him credit. Mm-hmm. Said, Poke and Bean, Malibu, Lake Man, Motown, The Heights. Really? T-Rock in the building. Go ahead. Mm-hmm. You doing the most. So, Robin from Baton Rouge. Hey, how you doing? So, okay. So, y'all know we're going back and forth between Facebook and Instagram Live. All that good stuff. So, also, the topic tonight was about, has your cell phone, is your cell phone causing problems in your marriage? So while we are still waiting on people coming, yes, I can't deal with him. She gave you some credit. Tell again, Tanisha.
You missed it. She was talking to my mom, you put this together and all this kind of mess.
We're not going to have this conversation right now. This is a night of love. Black love.
No, Valentine's over with.
Oh, okay. So anyway, what was I saying?
Cell phone.
Has anybody had a problem with their cell phone in their relationship? Whether your spouse said that you spend too much time on it. You know, has anybody had a problem? Has it caused an argument or a fight in your marriage? What, Tanisha? Don't be petty.
There you go.
Don't be petty, okay? So, anybody? I'm trying to multitask.
It caused a problem in our relationship.
Okay, it said. Somebody say used to. Somebody say yes. Somebody say no. So on Facebook, has anybody had a problem? Has their cell phone caused a problem or an argument or any kind of craziness in your marriage? Yes, he told me I showed the phone Facebook more attention than him. Woo! Now that right there, Donna, is a whole crux of what we're going to be talking about tonight. You gotta go to up top. To your page. I've talked to the very first one. All right, it says, yep, his cell phone was off limits. If I'm even near it, he would skydive to ensure that I didn't see what was on it. Hence, we are divorced. You know what, Jay?
She said skydive.
Wow. Okay, so we did a little thing about how do you things to know if you are addicted to your cell phone? And so I'm going to jot some of these down though, because you said you pay more attention to phone. Okay, so I cut it all the way. Okay, well that was a good thing, Donna. Only with Insta because I post too many pictures. Okay, but the thing about it, when I say your cell phone, that's still your cell phone. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, games, anything like that is still your cell phone. And so, you ain't in the shot, but you gotta be in the picture now. I mean, we're doing the video because they'll be coming behind me in there.
talk.
All right. Cheryl says she guilty. Okay. My husband plays games all night. I just go to bed. Okay, so now I was a social media junkie. Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, everything. He's not a social media junkie, but he is a game junkie.
I'm not no game junkie.
Oh my God, the first step to getting help is admit you have a problem.
Yes, her name is Angie.
My husband plays games on his phone and he loves eBay. So the same issues that I had with him, that he had with me, I have with him with his games. So what I was going to talk about is ways to find out if you are addicted. Okay, so I'm going to ask some questions. I would like for you to yes or no in the comments. This is for Facebook and Instagram Live. Okay, it says one way to know that you are addicted to your cell phone is when you check your phone to see the current temperature instead of going to the door or the window. Now, back in the day, I know that seems like old school for everybody that's our age or younger, but that's what they did before. They would either check the news or they would go outside and check the temperature. Like, you got up in the morning, is it cold? Is it yes? It's cold. Is it cold? Is it hot? You would go to the door because, like, when the temperature now, you read the temperature on the phone, it'll say it's so cold, but then when you go to the door, then it's not, the temperature's not the same. You know what I'm saying? Like, the, right. Like it could say it's, like, what was it, last week? It said it was 45 or something like that, but you said it don't feel like that outside.
It wasn't cold, right?
Yeah, so it said yes for both, okay? So, you know, get back to checking the actual temperature. You can look on the news or whatever, but, you know, we usually just open the door to see the temperature of what's outside. It says, when you have to consciously say to your spouse, let us put our phones away. If you go on a date with your spouse or if y'all are doing something, you have to say, let's do this without the phones, then you guys could be addicted to the phones. Because if you have to make it, known, don't use the phone, then you have a problem. Why you laughing?
Okay.
So, but most relationships, if you go to a restaurant right now and you see a couple sitting at a table, both people have phones.
Most of the time.
If you have children, most people, the kids and the children are on the phone. Yeah. And so, hence you don't create memories. You are looking on Facebook, taking a picture of what y'all doing, where y'all at, what y'all eating. But you're not creating memory with your kids and your children at all. So, that being said, I said, I don't say that, but my husband does and threatens to take it. So, T-Berry, if your husband has a threat in you to take your phone, that could be an indication that you're addicted to your phone.
Right. Then I'm with Jay Nicole.
What's she saying?
She says that society is addicted to phones. Beepers were the best invention. Cell phones have hindered social interactions.
True.
I love me a pager. Yeah, I wish we can go bike.
Go back?
Go bike.
All right.
And don't forget to share to people on Facebook Live down there in the left-hand corner.
Right. Share to your page so people can join. Do I have to give my mama? You definitely give your cell phone. You so addicted to that phone, Lord Jesus. All right, so if you're...
We in Orlando, Florida, Michelle.
Okay, so now the next one says, you know that you're addicted to your phone if you're answering emails and texts while you're waiting for a massage or something that's supposed to distress you. So just say if you went to go get a pedicure, if you went to go and... do something that's supposed to be relaxing, but the whole while you're there, you're answering emails and texts, work, business. You're just trying to do all this stuff before you get done. We used to take a picture of us before of what we eat. Okay. Our rule when we are out as a family is to turn phones in upside down on a table and be present with each other. Now, Mildred, that's good, but actually, the studies have shown that if your phone is out, then it's still saying that there's a priority to your phone as opposed to the people you're with. So the best thing is to leave it in a car or put it in, I collect everybody's phone and put it in my purse. Because, you know, if there's an emergency, of course, you know, but most of my family is with me. You gotta get in this shot because this one we upload to YouTube and you're not in it at all.
Okay, go ahead.
So, putting the... What's the purpose of your phone being on the table and upside down? If it's not important and your family is getting the priority, then it needs to be put up. All right, say, will you take a picture? Okay, so good evening.
You missed your mom. Say, I know you didn't say that.
Yes, mama. I actually, as my mom is talking junk to me right now, but she said something now because I don't hardly ever answer my phone. That people can't get me like they used to. Well, I left my phone home like 3 or 4 days out of the week, did I not? Mm-hmm. Because now it's not glued to me. I have made it not to be a priority. So that means that, hence, before if it was a priority, if I left my phone, I got to come home and get it. I got to turn around. I knew that I didn't have my phone in my hand because that was just always attached to me. But now that's not the case. But it can be a deal.
Multitasking. I guess she's saying why she waiting on the massage or whatever.
I mean, I'm not going to disagree. I'm just saying these are things to think about. Who is this paging me at 5:46 in the morning?
Oh, yeah. Jesus. I feel you, Jay.
Really? Really, Jay?
Because you got sidetracked.
Obviously.
Yeah.
All right. So the other said,
Leandra said good evening.
Hey, Leandria. Okay, so just say if you go to, hey Chelsea, if you go to get dinner for everybody and your children have to text you their order because you're going to forget. Now, a lot of us can't remember simple things. Why is that? Because our cell phones have replaced our memory. A lot of the games and activities that they have that we used to do that would sharpen our memory was basically using our memory, right? Mm-hmm. Like, you know, we would go somewhere, you'd be like, okay, you want cheese, you want number one, you want number two, you want whatever. But now we just rely so much on a text that we can't remember simple things. So even so much as spelling words. Like, you know, have you ever had a time where you can't spell the, and you like, you're laughing because you're like, it's so dumb, I can't remember a simple word. That's because we have found ourselves relying on our cell phone has replaced our common thoughts, our memories, our thought process, normal stuff.
And one of the popular games that I played when I was young was actually memory. You know, the matching, remember which card is where.
Wasn't that like Old Maid or something too? Yeah, you remember talking about when you had to like
match.
Yeah, when you would turn the card over, and you had to remember. But we can't do that now because our memory is so bad. So cell phones are good in one instant, but it's horrible at another. Okay, so I find myself in a better mental space without my cell phone. Chelsea, and that's actually what I was going to say, I would have thought not because, you know, it was a time that Cedric and I got into it because he said I was always on my phone. And I was thinking, like, I'm not on social media. I had stopped doing the, I was like, I'm not on social media, but I had to have my phone in my hand. I had to be, even if I wasn't doing it, going through the pages or touching something, but it had become an addiction. It's just like a drug addict. Even if they're not, you know, drinking a drink, they fidgeting with their bottles of liquor that they still got around. It's almost like you're teasing yourself. And so the best way to free yourself from that is to actually free yourself. You have to remove yourself from the situation and prioritize. You were not in this shot, baby. I'm fuzzing at him because our YouTube, we put
this
on.
This one.
Baby, that's not going to go on YouTube. That goes away. So this is the priority.
All right. Michelle says that her girlfriend's husband sleeps with his phone and she feels like that's wrong.
I agree. There is something that is lacking when your phone has to be with you when you're asleep. First of all, there's some serious side effects to the radiation that comes with the phone and being with your phone. But the other part of it is, you know, it causes a lot of doubt and mistrust in marriages and relationships too, because like somebody said earlier, they're divorced now, but what happens when you get the phone and you can't touch your husband's cell phone? You can't use his cell phone. If his phone ringing, you know, he diving, or he taking it in the bathroom, or he, like, okay, what is on his phone that you can't share with your spouse? Like, I don't want to touch your phone, but if his phone rang, I can answer it, and I'm not going to get in trouble or check for it.
Yes, you get in trouble.
I'm going to get a whooping?
Nah, I don't know about all that. You get in trouble. You time out.
My phone is very important, but I do know how to disconnect.
Right.
Now, I would ask your husband that question, T-Berry, and I guarantee I get a different answer because I said the same thing and my husband thought something different. Mildred says, I agree with that. I used to store all phone numbers in my head. Now I know just a few by memory. Right. And Mildred, now that right there is...
Right. If you had to get a phone number out of your brain, you'd be in trouble.
Right. You know, and it's so funny because, God forbid, anybody go to jail. Jail, you don't have your phone. They take everything. And, I mean, it could be a misunderstanding, a mishap, but you get one phone call, and right. You don't know anybody number hard.
Nobody number.
Your phone goes dead. You stranded. You had a payphone. You can't call nobody.
They still have those?
Yes, very few, but they have them. Or somebody said, use my phone, and you have no idea of how to get in contact with anybody because you know no numbers by heart.
Call 911 to have police go to the address. Tell my people to call 911. I can't. And let me know.
But listen, but think about how important that is. If your cell phone, because cell phones have problems, battery go dead, phone stop working all together.
Oh, your no phone, service where you
no
are.
Service. Well, Steve, no service ain't it, because you can look at the number while you got service. If your phone jacked up, and I don't know if anybody's phone ever been wiped out, could be an issue of avoiding your mate. And you know what, Shalette, that's very true. Avoiding your mate, avoiding your situation, avoiding things that's uncomfortable, that could be your comfort. But being comforted by something else,
like a teddy bear,
it is an addiction, because that's what people that do drink alcohol or drug addicts, that is their comfort. So they avoid their situation by indulging in alcohol, overdoing it. They avoid their situation by going into drugs. People that cut, what are the things they do, babe?
Eat.
Over, you know, indulgence with eating. Whatever your addiction is.
Sex.
Oh, that's right. They do have sex addiction now. Sex.
Well, no. People just use sex to escape from the reality of whatever they try to numb themselves from whatever they're feeling.
Well, infidelity. Because they start having outside relationships right. To make them feel better. But it only lasts while they're intimate. But when they're done, they feel worse because they've cheated on their spouse. But then also, they're now... back to the problems they had, and they've added more on top of that. All right, so we're at 4, so we're going to go to 5. When you're on your way, so most of us have the whole theory of don't text and drive, but what a lot of us that are very smart and slick try to do is wait till we get to a light. So this one says, you could possibly be addicted to your phone, is when you hope that you hit a bunch of red lights on the way home, just so you'll have time to respond to Facebook, to a text.
Or email.
It's definitely an addiction when it's obsessive and causes you to avoid the normal communication. But now, I agree, Shalette, but isn't that the way most people do now? Like, most people, and if you talk to people about their cell phones, they'll say they are not addicted. I can put it down. I can stop. I don't have to, like...
Right.
You know, it took me a little while because I felt like I was just doing that because I was bored. And my husband's still not, he still ain't went to rehab. He still don't realize he addicted to that them games and eBay.
Oh.
He cannot sit on anywhere without that games and eBay.
I do it all the time. It's called work.
Okay. So does anybody ever hope that they hit some street lights on the way home, some red lights on the way home, to respond to a Facebook post or a text or email at the light real quick? You said, I need my phone, it's work. Cheryl, and I understand that. Listen, let me tell you something. I use that same excuse, Cheryl, but you have to have a balance. And like Shalette just said, I think it was overindulgence. I don't remember the exact word she used, but anything, you have to have separation. You have to have balance. And if you are always on your phone, even for work, it is a distraction and you're still addicted to it. You cannot have a job that has you where you have to have your cell phone 24/7, because if you are focused on your cell phone, then your husband and your children are lacking. You cannot have both of them. It's how I stay organized. And it's, listen, don't get me wrong. I got a bunch of calendars. I do social media for different organizations. So I have about 15 different social media accounts for different people that I run. So what I had to do was only give myself a window to get those things done. When it's time to post those things, I post them, or I'll schedule, or I might set like an hour where I'm doing them. But I make it on my time, not where the phone is calling me. I'm like Pookie on, what was that, Friday? I know that was New Jack City.
No, yeah.
He's like, oh my God, it's calling me. I can't do it. Boundaries, correct. There has to be boundaries.
Boundary limitations.
And whenever you start to say, I got to use it for this, or I got to use it for that, or I got to this, that is a big indicator that you have a problem. Absolutely not to waiting on the red lights. Okay, well, Mildred, good for you, because I was definitely addicted to that. Yes, you can set realistic boundaries. Yes, you have to set boundaries. If you don't, it's like anything else. You, if you have blended families, you have to set boundaries with the ex or the baby mama, baby daddy, because it can be
blending.
Because it can become a problem. So you have to set boundaries. Now, you could have a good relationship and have no problems, but there, in order for things to work, it has to be boundaries and limitations.
I agree. I came up with another, you might be addicted if.
Okay, go ahead.
If you're texting people in your family and everyone is at home, you might be addicted to your phone.
Now, are you addicted to your phone or are you lazy?
Both.
So how many will text your children or text your,
like, I get texts when I'm in the living room, or you in the bedroom.
Did you hear him? He said he get texts when he in the living room. Okay.
I'm gonna drink my water.
That's your sip of your tea. Anyway. Yeah. Anyway. So.
See, she said that's me.
Right. Well, that's the thing. I mean, I will text him. And the other, but usually it's because I'm asleep and his TV be so doggone loud.
Whatever.
He have it on like he in the, that's lazy and I'm good. Like, Janelle, I feel like it's because I'm lazy, not because I'm addicted in that particular thing. All right, so you got it from, okay.
Shalette says, is that addiction or convenience? It's both?
I say it, now that one could go either way.
That's convenience.
Convenience. It's lazy because I don't want to get up. That's lazy, because okay. I don't want to get up to come tell you something.
That's another topic for us.
Well, this is the thing. I be calling his name, but the TV's so loud he can't hear me. So then I text him.
I just ignore you.
He said ignore me. Y'all ain't going to help me. He said he ignored me.
I'm just kidding.
No, he not.
I would never do that.
Because when he finally do answer me, he act like he aggravated with me and with me calling him. So that means he know I've been calling him.
No.
My mom used to call from her bedroom when I was in the kitchen. Wow. She said I got unlimited calls, so. I definitely do that. It's called being lazy. I'm going to go with lazy on that one. Although I will do it. I personally hate texting. I prefer to make a call. Now, I am definitely a phone call person. I really hate when people send you, I call them a book. When the book is when they send you a text and it roll over to another page, or it's in different increments of the same text because it's so long, that lets you know that's too long.
It's been a long time texting.
So they can pick up the phone and have a conversation. Like people trying to plan on where you're going to go eat. Where you want to go, I don't know where you want. Let's pick up the phone, have a 5-minute conversation, and we're done. But what we do is we tend to...
That conversation is not 5 minutes with women.
We're not, that's another day. Okay. All right, so... It says when you make a decision based on your phone, when you make a decision based on your phone, the outfit that can hold your phone better. Anybody ever known that they can't take their purse, or they're gonna be at work and want to tuck their phone? So I'm gonna put on these pants because my phone will slide in my pants, as opposed to if I had on a skirt or a dress, it won't fit in there.
That's
okay. So T-Bear say no. I was guilty. I would wear something that I could have my phone in, slide my phone in, as opposed to in my hand. Well, I mean, I'm not the only one. Hey, Shayna.
Ms. Collier says, people don't answer anymore, but will respond to your text.
Oh, my God.
That's kind of true.
But you know what, though? To me, that is not, you don't respect the other person, because... You want me, first of all, most people are trying to communicate while they're driving. So you would rather have me text you back and forth, read these long books while I'm driving, as opposed to picking the phone, having a few minute conversation, hey, I'm a few minutes late, hey, this, that, and the other, while we're trying to decide. correct?
Yeah, I don't got nothing to do with that.
Okay. So it says, when you hold it, if you grab your phone. Okay, so if you grab your phone in the middle of the night when you're going to use the restroom to check Facebook, text, or a game, use the technology for convenience of us both.
You can text me if you're in another room because I'm sure not going to get up and walk to another room just for you to tell me something stupid.
He said silly.
Same thing.
Really, James? Don't do that.
I feel your pain.
Right. Have a car accident or something. Right. Guilty. Okay, Shell's guilty of that one. And all these things I was guilty of. Although, I know actually not that one. Because I didn't check my phone in the middle of the night. Now when I went to the bathroom, I went to pee and came back.
You didn't check your phone in the middle of the night.
I did not check my phone in the middle. How would you know? You sleep.
You would wake up and check it. You'd be over there snoring.
If it went off, that was true. That was true. All right. That was true now. All right. So if you have ever dropped your phone because you're dozing off. Now, I want to see the responses to this one.
I done did that one many times.
If you have dropped your phone because you were dozing off, you could be addicted. I really like you guys. I like what you guys are doing. Keep doing it. Sorry, I got to leave. It's too late here in Paris. Oh, my gosh, you're in Paris. Well, thank you for joining us so much. We're on Facebook Live, so if you want to go replay the video, you can on Facebook Live. I just saw you on Twitter. Okay, said no. Tell the truth and shame the devil. Go ahead.
Michelle says she pulled over just to text. She addicted.
Oh, my God, yes. We're going to send you to rehab. Slap me in the face. Yeah. Yes, guilty, Sheridan. To Shana, hey, God bless and glory. Hey, Nia, hey, I've done that. Right. So if you've ever dozed off and dropped your phone because you're behind dozing off, then that's a problem. Because at the point when you're sleepy, the normal thing, the proper thing is to put your phone down and go to bed. Right. But we don't do that. We try to finish what we're doing to the very end.
The last little bit.
I've done that. Right.
Many times.
Okay.
Might did that last night.
Alrighty, if you okay. When you what's that? Okay, so when you are staring at your photos you took on your phone while you're at the actual event is taking place. Right? So okay, let me say it again. When you're actually staring at the photos that you took on your phone at the event while the actual event is taking place. Right. So just say you're at a wedding and you took pictures of the wedding, they look good. So you back looking through the pictures on the phone of the wedding, but you're still at the wedding.
Right. And you putting the filters and all that mess on so you can post them.
Yeah. You don't get you Cheryl, can't
guilty.
You cannot enjoy the moment if you're trying so hard to capture the moment and filter the moment and post the moment. And I get that it doesn't mean that you might not take a picture together and post it, but you can't, we can go to an event, take a picture, and then post it and take other pictures and then post them later. But if you're at the event and you're missing stuff because you're trying to post and filter and share and see who wrote what and comment back.
Well, that's what I need to understand. What's with all, you just can't take the regular pictures. You got to put like words and stuff on it and sepia and all this kind of, I don't want to get
those are filters. I mean, I'm not a big filter person like that, but a lot of times the filters give you a different effect. And so people like to play, like if it's not the right lighting, one of the filters might lighten it up.
So everybody a photographer now.
Well, the phones make everybody think they're a photographer. They make everybody think they all this. And it's not the case.
Michelle said, I feel sick without my phone. I just realized I'm addicted.
Michelle, you're not the only one. But baby, let me tell you, we're going to finish some of these things, okay? Again, Facebook on the left-hand side, if you would share it to your page so people can join, they can see. Because there's a lot more people that's addicted to their phone. I'm surprised Facebook ain't block us. We're talking about addiction, so we want to help you out on Facebook.
Cheryl say no filter, just captions.
Well, okay, so captions, filters, everybody has their own niche, but it's still a problem. Right. Now all I need to make sure I have a good picture while I'm there.
Oh, Lord.
Tanisha, really.
Terrence, look at said. Showing up. What's up with all these filters? You get me? I don't understand it. Like, you got to put words on it and all this. I don't get it. Terrence Jefferson say what's up.
Right. All right, so it says if you have to, okay, So another way of knowing if you're addicted, I want to see yes or no's, if you have to have your cell phone in your hand when you're alone. If you home, you by yourself, your cell phone is in your hand.
Or very close by.
I was guilty. And I say it was because I'm no longer guilty.
Yeah, I leave my cell phone everywhere. That one never my problem. I don't know where it be.
You know the good picture check, right? No? Okay. This is the thing I want to say. Social media could be your job. Something you get paid. A girl said, her watch. That's bad, Cheryl. Very close by.
There you go.
Okay, so if, like, I get paid to do cell phone, social media for different organizations. However, I was letting that be an excuse for my addiction to my phone.
Right.
And it doesn't mean that I still can't do that. I had to prioritize it. It didn't have to be every day, all day. It didn't have to be in the middle of a conversation, me and my husband, and it had to be all the time. But I had to understand that most time it's on the charger. But I had to realize, because, you know, even in ministry, like for people that are in a church, like I don't know if you noticed, but a lot of ministers and musicians, they go Facebook Live all the time. But if they have a significant other, a spouse, have you thought about how that makes them feel? Because I know that I wanted to go Facebook Live all the time, and he was like, I don't feel like it. And I used to think, like, why? Da 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 da. And he was like, they'll be all right. And I had to realize my priority was my husband, not Black Love, not Ced and Angie, not going Facebook Live. You have to put things in perspective. I said, no, when I leave my phone at home, I refuse to turn around and go. But no, we're not talking about leaving your phone home. If you're home by yourself, your phone is usually in your hand. Please tell him. What's that? Please tell him.
I don't know. I missed it.
All right, T-Berry. T-Berry, I think you did a typo over here. All right, so say, where's your cell phone right now? Now, of course, we're all on Facebook Live and Instagram Live, so that's it's probably in your hand. However, in any given moment, your cell phone is usually in close proximity of where you are. What did that say? Okay, it says, okay, about to go somewhere and you're in your car, you're driving down the street and realize you forgot your phone. Pull over to make
sure if you have it.
To make sure you, oh yes, I turn around and go get it. I used to, because I was addicted to it, but I don't do that anymore. I may call when I get to work and say, hey, is my cell phone there? He'll say, yeah, then that's what it is. Or I'll go look on the thing and see, find my iPhone. If it says it's at my home, that's where it is. No, it's in my car upstairs, etc. Okay. Well,
that's good.
For the normal people that's addicted, but 98% of the world that's addicted to cell phones, yeah, or a laptop or a tablet, watch, headphone says praying for
iPad, something.
Right. People are, Android, I mean, I'm saying your cell phone, but if you're addicted to electronics, social media, social media, you know, whether yours, because everybody have a different niche. Everybody's trying to Snapchat everything. Why y'all Snapchat riding down the road listening to your music? I can't understand it for the life of me.
My son do that too. I don't know. What's that about?
I don't know. I mean,
are you showing the scenery where you're going, or and the music? I mean,
Tanisha, you need to answer that one, because that's what you do too. Them youngsters do that. They snap. I ain't gonna say young. I just seen some old people doing that, Snapchatting they song and riding down the road. Like,
right. Thank you, Michelle, for tuning in. Have fun at work.
Yes, enjoy. Thank you, Michelle.
Don't work too hard.
All right, say okay. So if you had to live without your cell phone for a week, would you be lost?
Yes. See that? She said, who's more addicted, men or women? I say women. Because women always Snapchat and Instagramming and all
that. I say both, because you don't know it because you're not on there to see it. But when we go somewhere, and if you go to a function,
I'm saying when I see you checking yours, because I hustling yours, I'll be mostly chicks on there.
No, but it's both.
I don't know. I mean,
I can go to 20 of your friends that do it. And it's weird because you don't do it, so it's so odd when I see all the guys that do it. But guys do it too.
Yeah.
But guys don't do a picture of themselves. Like, we take selfies and put pictures of ourselves. They do other stuff, like the pictures of liquor bottle or the car or something else. But they still do it.
I got a liquor bottle here to take my picture.
Go get you some liquor.
Give me a picture. Go take the picture in the liquor store and leave it there.
Jane says it's women. Right. Tina says both. Nia says yes.
I just say women. I'm just going to say
my that. Husband, on the other hand, is on his person at all times. Okay? So.
She the opposite.
Right.
See, Michelle say women. Before she leaves. That's right.
Michelle, get off here.
Pizza say she's a selfie queen. Exactly.
But most women are selfie queens. It's not the men that you.
T-Bear say her husband posts everything. It's so annoying.
But you know, that's the thing, though. Like, when you talk to them about their addiction and them posting, do you notice whether your husband or wife are talking to you or you talking to them that they get so defensive? Okay, what's that? She say men, okay. Do you notice that if you talk to your spouse or your spouse talks to you about being addicted or not being on your phone or your tablet a lot, that you or them, whoever's the one that's being accused, get really defensive? Both my son is on there.
Well, yeah, it's a little different for the teenagers and the
but baby. If they don't correct that now, it's gonna roll over into their marriage. They don't get married and say, "I want to stop."
I'm saying for the 35 and older crowd, I think the women got it. For the young, everybody on there, all of them on there, like every 5 minutes you see them on there.
Look at Manny talking about yes. No, don't do that, Manny. Yeah, don't co-sign with Cedric.
The teeny bobbers get crazy with it. Like, they can't take 5 steps without something. I don't understand it. Like,
Well, you know, the thing about it, what hit me most was, a question for you. Do you live in the moment? I want to hear some answers. Do you... whatever your name is, live in the moment. Ced, do you say you live in the moment?
Sometimes. Okay. But I don't think the technology necessarily prohibits me from living in the moment.
Okay, but I'm not asking what prohibits you. I'm just saying, do you live in the moment?
It's your beauty. Mesmerizing.
You're so extra.
I can't even see what's going on out here.
Manny says yes. Nia says sometimes. And some of the rest of it, she's rude. Okay.
I think a lot more than I used to.
Sometimes, yes. Right. But we had a conversation about it.
Say sometimes, too.
Okay. Look, I actually preached a message about living in the moment. And say most of the time. Okay. So, James said most of the time.
Most of the time.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So, has ever... show you something. And you answer. All right. So, have you ever been riding down the road to somewhere you go all the time, and someone show you something, a whole building, or a building gone, and you're like, when did that get there? Has that ever happened to anybody? Me, I'm going to tell you, me, I definitely was guilty of that. Let's say I'm guilty of never capturing it in photos.
So that means she lived in the moment.
Okay, so has anybody ever... had something pointed out? Cheryl said yes. Mm-hmm. You riding down the road, your kids say, "Mama, look at that." You like, "When did that get there?" A whole building. Old building used to be there, new building there now, or whatever the case may be. Don't get ice.
I really don't.
That is because we're not necessarily living in the moment. You are so busy doing all the time. You're so busy doing other things every day, all day. Even when you're driving, you are always like, "I gotta do this, I gotta do that." Your mind is so preoccupied that you just don't look at your surroundings, see what's around you. Right. Oh, they're tearing this building down. Oh, there's a new building coming in. Maurice said, "Yep." So unless a row.
You missed the whole city of Claremont?
Really? Really, Maurice? But this is the thing. It's not... Okay, so, like, it's roads that I travel all the time that they are tearing a building and build another one. You like, when did that happen? Or you look and it's almost completed. That's because you just don't... You don't look and enjoy the scenery. You know, whether you're fussing at your kids, you're on your phone, you are... doing a whole bunch of other stuff, but you're just not enjoying your journey. You're just kind of like, I'm trying to get the day over, get to where I gotta go, get the day over so I can start this all over again. You in a routine, not just enjoying life. All right, so, hold on, what was I doing?
Has anyone ever showed you something and you answered it not without looking?
Oh, yeah. Okay, so have you ever, so has your spouse or whoever you're with ever said, man, look at that right there. And you be like, mm-hmm. And you don't look at it. You just nod. Or you answer without looking. Like they'll say, look at that car right there. And you'll say, like, that's nice. You're like, yep. You ain't look. Okay, that happened to me. This was a while ago, but... my husband was showing me a whole bunch of cars that I didn't want to see.
It wasn't even a car, I don't think.
It was a car. You had showed me a couple of them. And he showed me one. Neil said yes. He showed me a car. I did look at the first one. I looked at the second one. But I was on my phone. Now, I kept looking up.
The whole story. You ain't looking at none of them.
I did. But the last one, I just said, mm-hmm. And then he said, you ain't even look up. And at that moment, I was kind of like, oh, man, I didn't look up. I was guilty because I didn't even look up. I just said yes and uh-huh. And I didn't even bother to look at what he was trying to show me. So for more than one reason, that showed him that what he was trying to show me wasn't important, that I wasn't paying attention to him, that my phone was more important,
right.
that
the phone had priority.
The phone. You know what your priorities are by what you spend your time with and on.
Right.
Say I've been sick for a week. You've been hitting the gym, I see, or is Angie's supper
super cute hair and glasses.
Oh, wow. Cool. Okay, Kwanda came in.
I say A.
You been hitting the gym? Minnie, don't you been sick, baby. Baby, you been sick. Yep. You seen enough. Right. So But it's still important because if we were talking to our husband and telling them something and they don't pay attention to what we do, we're going to have a hissy.
Conniption.
We're going to be fussing, you don't care, you're not important, what I show, da da da. We're going to go, right, automatic responses. But that's not good because what that leads to is problems in your marriage because you can't tell me he got to listen to you, but you can't listen to him.
Right.
Or, like... I don't like football. It's not a thing of mine. But I watch football with him, and I've actually enjoyed some things I learned because I know that it's important to him. It's times that I'll just sit and watch it with him. Flip my house, flip my butt, design on a dime, design this curve, curve your neck, curve your nuts, something. I don't know what else we curving, but I've watched those shows with him because I know they're important to him. And I've actually enjoyed some of them, but I had to... do the same thing I want him to do with me. I can't say, watch stuff you don't like, but then I won't do the same thing for him.
Yeah, I watched The Girlfriend Wanna Be Wise and all that.
No, we ain't movie watching.
Side pieces and the bucking and the ducking and the...
Oh, he's about Bringing On. I do watch Bringing On now.
Yeah, nasty little heifers.
All right. All right. Have you ever realized that one of your children, your spouse, your family member is fully involved with something that you didn't realize that they were involved with or that had gotten to that level? For instance, your child might like to play basketball. And you know they go dribble the ball every now and then. Next thing you know, people recruiting them to be on their AAU team because they the junk around town and you didn't even know they was good like that. Or... if your child can draw, like my daughter, and I would better say I paid attention, but I don't even know how she went from drawing the little bit of stuff she drew to drawing those serious pictures that she's done.
Because she was drawing all the time.
What I'm saying, but, like, it wasn't like she wasn't drawing all day. She just brought a picture out. You know what I'm saying? Like, we knew she drew. She just got better.
Right, that's what I'm saying. But she was practicing all the time.
Right. But have you ever had a child that you like, oh, where did you get into that? All right. So then we got, what do we miss when we spend too much time with technology? I got to switch to my tablet. I need my phone to post.
See?
That's a shame. What do you miss when you spend too much time with technology? She said sleep. That's right. A good one.
That's true.
Memories, life moments, love.
You miss things that your spouse is trying to tell you when you need to be reading between the lines.
Right, right. That, you know, and what to sex, right. Those times when, you know, your spouse might come lay with you and they try, like, man, you say, well, I ain't never getting none and da 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 da, but she could come lay on you and you too busy playing your game or doing whatever that you don't catch the hints, because she might not just go naked running around the house. It might be something subtle. Yes, Maurice, you missed it earlier. We said people can't even remember their own phone, remember phone numbers. If you got arrested, your phone went dead, you were stranded. Not many people have phone numbers by memory anymore because we just hit a button to hit a person's name.
Phone numbers, addresses.
Oh, God.
Directions, how to get to somebody's house.
Somewhere that you've been a million times.
And I have no idea without the GPS.
Oh, my gosh. I mean, I thank God for GPS for people like me because I'm directionally challenged. That's with or without a GPS. But I do believe that the smartphone has caused us to be dummies.
Right.
So we said that we miss sex, we miss sleep, we miss moments, we miss opportunities. I agree with sleep. You better be up all night.
I agree.
You be up all night strolling through the phone when you could have been asleep. True enough. It types it for us, correct. So a lot of times, I found that I'll type something, and I got a bunch of misspelled words. Why? Because I'm used to doggone autocorrect. Yeah. So if I'm trying to write a letter, and I'm like, dang, that don't look right. I got to look up how to spell a word that I should know how to spell because cell phones have made it so easy for autocorrect.
But
right, sex, you mean?
But this is the thing, too, people really don't realize, is it more important than just spelling, but grammar in general, because when you're forming sentences.
Oh, they're texting, though. That text talk. Yeah, because
they use a short sentence structure text and all talk. That's not real English structure. So if you have to write a formal something and you have to hand write it on paper, you're in trouble.
Like, okay, so in college, you have to write theses and all kind of crazy stuff that's long. But now,
on computer.
We all do this whole, when somebody reply, they'll say K, not OK. How lazy is it for you to write K instead of OK? Laugh out loud is LOL. There's a whole, like, sometimes people write
just do the emoji.
BRB and GM. I was like, Or HB, HBD. Okay, so BRB is be right back. And the only reason I know, because your son was texting me all this stuff, and I was like, what in the devil? I had to go out the text to go. I said, boy, please just write the whole word.
You don't text me none of that stuff.
That burns me, right. And then, you know, I feel some type of way. I'm a birthday person. So you text me HBD. So you too lazy on my birthday to write happy birthday. HBD, I gotta decipher what the heck that means.
Look, they can just send you the emoji. Which one is
it? I'm doing one now. The youth are having a terrible time with sentence structure. Oh, this is the other thing. Parents, this is to you. Our children do not have social skills.
Right.
Why? The phone has taken the place of social skills. When you go, just say if all of us are in a room waiting on a meeting to start. We all don't know. Nobody knows each other. We're waiting on a meeting to start. And we're sitting there. What used to happen is that, hey, where you from? Oh, I'm from Tallahassee. Oh, okay. My mama from Tallahassee. You know, then somebody talking. You make friendships and develop relationships with people that you didn't know because what you did when you were waiting around other people is that we would have conversations. Hey, I heard your mom was sick. Yeah, she's doing better now. Oh, so your mom's doing better, da da da. I'm still praying for her. It shows concern. You have conversation. But children in the room now, they don't have social skills because when they're in the room, they're just going to be on their device.
Yeah, ask each other for their, what's your Twitter
name? What's your Snapchat name?
Yeah, and they start snapping each other in the room together.
I'm going to Snapchat you in the room instead of having a conversation. Right. If I had social skills earlier in my life, I wouldn't be, I would have been a millionaire by now. Right. You know, we miss out on opportunities because the person you're sitting next to you could be your next big break. The person that's sitting
networking.
Right. But we don't network. We get on social media to post something. But I'm telling you, opportunities has happened with people that God put in your place and in your life. But you miss it because
you don't know how to talk to people.
The kids don't know how to have conversations. They don't know how to deal with conflict. They don't know conflict resolution skills. You know, like the communication skills that we have learned and that we share about how you talk to your spouse and what keywords you say and don't say. Those things, those same things apply with your children.
With friendships.
Friendships.
Co-workers.
Everything. Yeah. My daughter, 17, has that, then asked for snaps. Okay. So I guess she's saying she has social skills. But majority of our children don't have social skills because of social media. We, as parents, have given them iPads, iPods, whatever else to occupy their time when we are busy. We don't want to be bothered.
That's the babysitter.
It's the babysitter, yeah. But it's also a reason why our children they have high rates of depression and killing themselves. Emotional instability because they don't know how to deal. Somebody don't like me, I'm tripping.
Right. Technology kills social skills, is what Nikki said.
That's true.
Amen about the networking. Cheryl says, my network is my net worth.
Right, but people don't network anymore.
Right.
Like, I go to, and so funny, because I go in the grocery store, and my children will be like, Mama, do you know them? Because I come out talking to everybody. Well, no, but I learned that growing up. You talk to people, you know, you have a conversation because you never know. That could be somebody you need to pray with. That could be somebody that's your next open door, your next opportunity.
Right.
You don't know what you have to offer them or what they have to offer you if you don't have a conversation. But, and I'm not saying go bother everybody, but hey, how you doing? Sometimes people just need a kind word. That's a pretty dress. You know what I'm saying? Da 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 da. Just simple stuff that we don't do anymore.
Right.
I was addicted to my phone and social media. I am no longer addicted to either one of them. Now, I get the opposite. People are so used to me being easily accessible that people have,
they get miffed with you.
Ooh, miffed. I didn't learn that in school. What miffed mean, baby?
Slightly upset.
I think they're more than slightly upset. Because now it's no more of a priority. So they're mad. Because they've always been able to get Angie on the phone. I cut off all of my notifications for social media. For Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. When I get your messages or I see is when I open it up. And that's on my terms, not the notifications. My husband said a good thing to me about the purpose of social media.
It's a distraction to keep you from being productive as you can be. That's why the notifications are there. So every time somebody posts something, it bing, hey, go look. Your friend changed their profile picture or they said whatever. And you on there looking and you don't just look at that. You scrolling. Timeline, you Facebook stalking.
Right, Nikki. It said her nephew thinks that I'm crazy. Because I talk, laugh, and sing with strangers. But you know what, though? I got friendships to this day that I met just randomly. Because, you know, you just don't ever... I mean, everybody you're going to meet not going to be in your church or not going to be in your neighborhood.
Right.
But just having a simple conversation to let people know there's still humanity, there's still nice people around. Everybody not a freak or a weirdo. But you won't know that if you just spent all your time... on social media. So cut off the notifications And Instagram Live, it's going to cut off in a few seconds. I'll go back on there.
T-Bear say she too busy living. She don't have time for the notifications. I'm going to hit back what Maurice says. The best book he read relating to this topic is How to Win Friends and Influence People by Dale Carnegie. Katisha said, yes, we lack people skills. Many ask, how did you break the addiction, Angie?
What I did was I first went and cut off all my notifications. Because I had time, like I read my Bible plan on my phone. There's apps on the phone where you read. It has like
a topic,
a devotion, and the scriptures go with. Like you have books. Well, I know I'm not gonna carry books around me, so I read that. So I cut off my notifications because I would go on there for my Bible plan. A notification pop up, I check it real quick and end up on there for an hour. So. Because that's the first thing I did. And every time I open up Facebook, it asks me, do I want to go back to my notifications? Do I want to cut them on? Don't miss anything. Don't miss.
Right.
So then I started to put my phone in my purse or wherever I'm not. So like when I go in the living room with my husband, my phone is in the room. When when I go somewhere now, like even driving, I put my phone in my purse in the back seat. Now, my phone answers in the car, so I can answer it on my steering wheel and talk out Bluetooth, but it just allows me not to be fidgeting and looking through my phone and not texting and driving, which is very easy to do, not wanting me to look at the phone on at the light, that kind of stuff.
Right.
So it was, and I had to make it my business to realize that when I'm with my family, I'm with my family. I'm with my husband, You know, in almost every company, in your manual, there is something about cell phones. We're not to use your phone at work, not to do this, what you can and can't do. And majority of us are very guilty with...
Everywhere I go, it seems like the employee be talking up a phone. Boy, they got the phone in their pocket.
And we've got so comfortable that if you get in trouble at your job about your phone, you look at them like they did something wrong. Like, what you mean I can't be on my phone?
It's my phone.
But they have... provisions in their manual, in their company policy about your cell phones, but we just don't adhere to it.
A lot of them places, you're not supposed to have them like on the floor where you're working, but people still have them in their back pocket.
You go to Walmart right now, people at Walmart, the people are talking on their phone at Walmart. They got the phones in their back pocket at Walmart. They listening to music while they stalking the shelf at Walmart, which are all against company policy at Walmart. Check their manual. It's all against it. You're on there all the time.
You're on their time. The people you're working for.
Right. But you would think that, and if you ask them for something, you are bothering them. If you cause them to have to stop a phone conversation, to turn off their music, you are bothering them.
Right.
And it bugs me. The other thing that I've noticed is that we have a big problem with everybody having these phone conversations on speakerphone. Why are we having said we make our kids put their phones away, have family time. Right, they will enjoy. So the other day I went to the dentist, and I'm gonna tell y'all this because I did have me a moment of out of controlledness. It popped out, it's crazy. I absolutely hate people talking on speakerphone. That's why they make headphones. That's why they make earbuds.
Too late to hold up to your ear.
Or just the way you're supposed to talk on the phone. Because I don't want to hear your phone conversation. And I think it's unfair for you to... Oh, God, Minnie, don't do that. Don't do the speakerphone. That's so... Oh, what's the word for it, Jesus?
Mm-hmm.
It's just not courteous.
Right.
It's rude. And, you know, first of all... I have no choice if I'm around you to hear your but to hear your conversation. How would you feel if your spouse has a lock on their phone? Then there's some other issues. We have a lock on our phone. We both have locks on their phone, but we have each other's code, so there's not an issue with if I want to use his phone. Like if we were out here on the couch and I want to call somebody, I could pick up his phone and call. I ain't gotta get permission. So you'll unlock this for me. I don't have to do all that.
Use my minutes. Then my minute.
Wait, you got a minute? Shut up. All right. Poor. What's that?
Poo-poo could be listening.
Right. All right. So I'm in a dentist's office. This one lady sitting beside me is listening to her soap operas out loud in Spanish. First of all, I don't know what they're saying. Secondly, it's loud and irritating. I have a lock on my phone. My husband has a lock. Okay. So, like, she's like, you hit the code. Blah, 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 blah. The whole time, I'm like, oh, my God. First of all, it's just loud. We're already in the business. Everybody talking. There's a whole bunch of sound stuff going on. It's just a lot of noise. I don't like a lot of noise, period, anyway. So, I'm listening up for, like, 20 minutes listening to this stuff in Spanish. So, then...
with 5 years.
But we don't have that kind of noise.
Okay.
So, then, somebody comes out waiting on whatever. She dials her phone number on... She dials her a number and calls it on speakerphone. And she's speaking Spanish. Now, I don't speak Spanish, so it's going to sound real bad. Blah, 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 blah. Both of them are in my ears, like, on loud. So after listening to this for a little while, yes, I feel like it's very rude and very disrespectful, but I kind of lost it. So who has the nervous breakdown? It's me. I was like, I don't want to listen to your dog on soap opera. I want to hear your conversation. That's what they make speakers for. Da, 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 da. I just lost it. Needless to say, everybody cut it off and it was quiet. Now, that might have been an overreaction.
Yeah, slight.
I don't think so. Why I can't be loud if you can be loud and listen to your soap operas and have your loud conversation? Which one is better?
You supposed to rise above it.
Angie, we putting you on. If I'd have been on Snap, I'd have choked them, but I didn't choke them. Mm-hmm. What I did was, you know, just basically tell them that I don't want to hear. It was on stereo. Yes, Maurice, I lost it. That's probably my biggest pet peeve is you having. My children right now cannot play a video game out loud. You turn it on silent or you put your headphones in. We are sure that they have headphones. Miss, don't laugh at me. We are sure that you have headphones so there's not, because, okay, like he said, we have 5 children. It's 7 of us. If all of us listen to different things, then
too much going on.
I can't hear. And then plus me, I have issues with my hearing, so I can't hear with background noise going on. So, you talking about 7 things going on one time? No. But they obviously got the picture. Why not put your headphones in? Why do you have to talk on your phone, on speakerphone? I digress. Needless to say, I am that person. If you do that around me, I'm going to be looking at you real good and crazy.
See, Marisa, they got to need to work on you. That's right. She needs prayer. Y'all pray for her.
What you say? And they have to work on you. Yeah. They ain't got to work on
stretch
me.
Stretch your hands to her.
They ain't got to work on me. I do what the phones are designed to do. I talk on them up to my ear. If I don't want up my ear, then I put on a Bluetooth or a headset. So that's not me, because I don't want to hear your conversation in English or in Spanish. Hello. Lord, I thought I was bad, but I don't know how. Whatever. Tell my sis that about her son is very annoying. True, true.
Yeah.
To feel important. But do you think it's to feel important? I think people don't really know how to work cell phones either. Like, people say, I can't hear. That's why I do it on speakerphone.
Well, they be holding the phone.
Right, they hold the phone. The ear part is not here. It's up here.
Right, hello?
Okay. Like, I'm going to talk about my parents. Lord Jesus. They anyway, you were like, baby, pull it down, sugar. Put it down. The ear part, baby, bring it on down. See the little speaker thing? That's for your mouth. Little other thing, it's for your ear. That's how you should go. Or what about people that do like this? Hey, all right. Nah.
That's a lot of work.
I think that's special, but that's their business because I don't have to listen to it. But I don't know if it's to feel important, Maurice, or if they just like to do it. Because I'm not even talking about, you know, a lot of times young people do that when they want to feel important. So you're like, oh, yeah, I'm going to make this money, blah, 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 that kind of stuff. But it's Spanish. It's white. It's older people in particular. Oh, my God. We went to, when I had my knee surgery, my doctor's office, it was like 3 older white ladies in there, the phone on speakerphone. Tell Junior to put my noodles on. What? I was like, I respect my elders, but boy, they about to get it. I had to take a walk. And
look, she said, man, that's what a speaker is in the mouthpiece.
Yes. And the problem is, you know, they got signs in every doctor's office, don't use your phone. Oh, I did say it too when I had my ring. I said, big old sign say, do not use your cell phone, and you're behind on speakerphone and out loud. They probably thought I was nuts. I don't care.
So y'all see what I got to deal with. Y'all pray for me.
Whatever.
Pray my
strength. So anyway, to wrap this up, since we've been on here, The purpose of breaking the addiction to your cell phone is to build intimate relationships with your family, your children, people that you want to be connected to. How do you do that? It's about close familiarity, friendships, togetherness, affection, rapport. You can't build rapport on a cell phone. I don't care what y'all talking about. You cannot build rapport on your cell phone. And it's so funny now because when I say stuff about cell phones, people are like, oh, Angie, you a dick. I used to be. I did. And it's been what? How long did you say now?
Been a minute.
A minute? My baby said a minute. That's very helpful. But I live in the moment. I enjoy the moments. And sometimes they say I get a little bad with it now. Because now that I'm not on them, I'm like, this is too much. If I see cell phones, I'm taking them.
Maurice said he hit the Walmart. Confirm those allegations for us, Maurice. The cell phone. Bridget said when her G-babies come over, they already know once they sing loud with the earbuds. And she call them and they can't hear it. She liable to cut one off.
Amen. Amen. I'm so frustrated with these doggone electronics and whatever they call it. So, say ways to become intimate. Be intentional. Be intentional. Things don't just happen. So, if I want to develop a relationship with Cedric, I have to spend time with him. It can't just happen to spend time with him. Hey, let's go on a date. Let's sit down and talk. Let's talk about our hopes and dreams. What are your goals? Where are you, you know, now? What's your plans? You have to be intentional. But we're not good at that anymore.
Right.
Go to number two.
Investing time to build intimacy requires that we unplug from
distractions,
aka devices, aka technology.
But listen, you know anything can be a distraction?
That's true.
Anything can be a distraction if it is causing problems in your relationship or if it's causing you to miss out on life and the positive things of life.
That is funny you said that. It makes me think about that insurance commercial with the white couple when they're supposed to be talking about their life insurance and they're doing everything in the house like, I'm raking the grass. I'm baking the cookies, I'm cleaning, and then the black people couple looking because they got their person there looking out the window like, it's a nice neighborhood. Like, what's wrong with these people over there?
Right.
They're doing everything they can to avoid talking about what's at hand.
And we're guilty of that, doing so much stuff to avoid dealing with real life stuff. I mean, we have to be intentional with our relationships. I mean, we and Cedric and I, marriage is what we do. We love marriage. Like Mildred is on here. Her and her husband do marriage where they are. Like we connect with other couples that do marriage in different states. We just love the Institute of Marriage and know that at some point in time we had a hard time and was looking like we couldn't make it and we made it. So we try to share that same passion. But at the same time, there's a lot of times that we have to reconnect with each other because we get so busy helping marriage that we neglect our marriage.
Right.
So we have to be intentional about investing back into our marriage. So it's funny that no matter what it is, church can be a distraction. You can do so much stuff at church that you're not doing stuff together.
Right.
You could be so saved that your focus is being saved and not your ministry to your spouse. You could be so busy in your workplace that your goal is so much your job that you're not spending time with your family and your spouse. So anything that's too much can be a distraction. So whether you can't say, oh, I'm at church or I'm ministering the word, anything.
Your spouse is your first ministry.
Everything, when you do things too much, it's a distraction and it becomes a priority. Well, and it comes out of line, becomes out of line.
Well, the key word is balance.
Balance. You guys seem to always work together. But you know, Maurice, we have times we don't. We've had times before we got on the broadcast. We fussed my, you did, well, you did it. I don't feel like doing it. But you know, we're not human. We have disagreements, but we've learned how to disagree fight fair, and keep it moving. Like, now we're not, I'm saying we, but it's probably me, not overreacting and being over the top, and then we're not talking. Say something.
That was all me.
Marcy, he played a good role. Bridget, yes, my husband and I do a date night every Thursday night, no phones. We have been doing it for about 25 years. It seems it makes the heart grow better. Yes, y'all crack me up. Well, you know, we are getting back to our date nights, and now they're not necessarily date nights. They are just...
Yes, because we're supposed to go on a date today, and the kids went.
Okay, so we were all... Everybody's off work today, so we were going to the movies. And I said, babe, let's take the kids.
I wasn't off. My thing fell through for the day.
Okay, well, he didn't have to work. Right. Okay, so everybody was home. Regardless of how you got home, you were home. Yes. So I said, let's take the kids. So we went to the movies with the kids. And when we got finished, we brought the kids back home. And then we went to eat. So we still had a date. We just went to the kids with the movie first. Mm. Yes, and just speaker,
boo,
phone, cop. Well, I got to be speaker, phone, cop.
Right.
If you read your manual... Your manual. It'll say, don't have dog on speakerphone in public.
Yeah, I don't think it says that.
Actually, it does. It says, out of respect for others, you know, use your headphones when it tells you that. It tells you, because all the phones now come, okay. The smartphones come with.
How many people reading the manuals?
Whatever. That's they behind them.
Not,
the reason.
None.
So it's the way that, because you don't use the phone the way it's supposed to be used, don't be mad at me, because I want to enforce it. Boom.
Did you say boom?
Boom.
Oh, Lord.
No? Yeah. But I really appreciate everybody on here. I really want us to work. Well,
Nikki asked what the topic was for next week. I thought you put it on the...
I did.
I don't know what it was. I wasn't paying.
Listen, when we get finished, I want you guys to go...
You're welcome.
...to our page and subscribe to the Black Folks Don't Write. They don't... go to our page and subscribe to the events that we have. We have it. It's usually every Monday night at 8:00. I did 7:30 this week because I'm trying to go to bed early. I know that sounds real crazy, but my life is.
And you still getting off about the same time.
Yeah, well, that means I got out much later then too. See that? Next week is. Do you have to change who you are to be married? If you will, on Facebook Live, will you hit on the left-hand side and click share to your page, please?
Because
people can still go back and look at this. I want you to subscribe to our YouTube channel, subscribe to our Black Love. You don't have to be married. The stuff that we talk about is stuff that you're going to need when you get married.
Well, and not only that, a lot of the techniques that we talk about is applicable in all your relationships.
It's applicable. My babe's smart. You heard it. Say it again,
friendships.
Babe. Turn me on. Say it again. It's a what?
Applicable.
Oh.
All relationships, you need to learn how to communicate.
Well, what is it? I missed 2 Mondays. But go on Black Love, Manny, go to Black Love page, the one you're on, right? Black Love United. Each week we have an event, but you can go back and watch them, all of them. They have topics from...
And they all on YouTube.
Why wives don't like to have sex.
Spock Thomas.
Right.
Yeah.
I can't remember all of them. We got next week is do you have to change
who you are
to be married? After that is love language. What's going on, y'all? Daryl, how you gonna come in so late? It's over, Daryl. Thank you for the lab break while I write my paper. Always a pleasure. Thank you, Cheryl, for joining in. Mildred, good night, my friends. I'm about to drop my phone. Sleepy.
I know, right?
Well, don't I appreciate it, Mildred. Mildred, her and her husband do a big deal. What they do, they're marriage advocates, and that's what we like.
Hey, Mildred, look, if you can't find it in the morning, look under the bed. I was under the bed. When you drop it, it go under the
people
bed.
People done cracked their screens for
every time.
Won't put that phone down. But Mildred, thank you for joining us. Tell Mark I said hello. When is the next couple get together? Can't wait to meet you guys. T-Bear, are you in Orlando? So next week, I do want you to go to our events and go on there. Next week, do you have to change who you are to be married? We have, and you know, usually it's the men that do this whole, I ain't gonna change who I am. I'm losing myself. Da 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 da. They got to be hard. They got to this. But what does the Lord say?
I was willing and able to give myself. I was pliable.
Oh, my husband was not.
Yeah.
He was probably the worst.
I was pliable.
My phone died. I'm sorry. He was the absolute worst when it came to making adjustments when he got married. He felt like he was losing all of himself.
I did. It was gone. Lord's gone.
He now, bucked. He now, we would just
look when people see me, they don't even know my name. It's you and your husband. Angie, I know you look familiar. You and your husband.
Oh my God. Let me tell you the funniest thing. I don't know if the person is on here, but in the morning I went to 7-Eleven before I went to work. I got out, I shut the door, and this guy had just got in the car, and when they backed out, they said, Angie, and I said, hey. And of course I didn't know who the heck it was. And they was like, the lady said, don't wreck your brain. You don't know us. We just follow y'all on Facebook. And I thought it was so funny because I was, Lord, I don't know who that is. Hey, John. Mr. Goldilocks.
Exactly. You and your husband, ain't you?
But you know what, Maurice? The funny thing about it is that now I call and I say, I'm Angie. They be like, Angie? And I was like, I just talked to you. They're like, hey, you mean Goldilocks? Baby, my name is Angie. Why are you still?
No, Goldilocks. That's your name. Angie's that government.
Anyway, unplug from your devices some.
Don't do it on Mondays at 8 o'clock when we on.
Right. You got to join us Monday at 8 o'clock. Do it before then.
Right. After we go off, then you unplug.
Tell them about it, babe.
Yeah. Dare I say you want a shirt? I got you.
You want a shirt? I got you. You got, how you got it, baby?
I don't know.
See? That's the dumb stuff. That's the dumb stuff he do.
Inbox me. You know, we'll talk about it. We'll figure it out.
Inbox you? Do you not even check the inbox? No.
It's on there.
He don't even know how to check the inbox. His people go inbox him and then inbox me. Inbox Black Love.
Inbox her.
Inbox Black Love.
Black Love. That,
oh my God. Stop telling people stuff that you don't check. You don't even know how to check.
I didn't say what the inbox. I didn't say inbox.
See, you said inbox me.
I was talking about Black Love me. Black Love. See? Ah, you like the way to work that thing out. Inbox me, Black Love. I'm
Help
black.
Him, Lord.
I'm black and I got love. Black Love.
Love on my mind.
Yeah, see, Doran said he want a shirt too.
Okay. Well, y'all have to inbox me. And,
yeah, surfing wings. Oh, I can do that. I like groceries.
You really? Maurice, you see, he down with it. He'd be like, he'll be calling you. Maurice, what's your number? Inbox me.
Hey, look, T-Bear want a shirt too. Y'all inbox it.
Well, you can't. I don't know if you. Well, y'all guess y'all can't inbox me on Instagram. Inbox me.
What you do on Instagram? Send a message of carry pigeon or something.
It's inbox, baby.
Carry pigeon.
It's inbox.
Just write a little note on the leg.
I really thank y'all for joining us. Again, before you get off on the left-hand side, please hit share and share it to your page so we can get some people to see this wonderful topic. We need more people that are living in the moment. Tell people don't inbox me. On Facebook and expecting a quick response. I have people that inbox me on Facebook that have my cell phone number. To me, that's dumb. If you got my number, then you need to inbox me, text me.
Oh, DM on Instagram. That's what it is?
It's still an inbox. Don't confuse him. Because he been around here saying, go down in the DM.
It go down.
Listen, he saw a snap. He don't even know. I saw that on a skating video. And now he talking about go down in the DM.
It's very catchy.
Right. So inbox us if you're looking for a shirt and your sizes, and I will get the stuff together because it's going to be mailed to you because I'm not going to worry about sending everything your way. It's too much light work. I'm not going to try to find them.
I'm saying mail it, send it to them.
Okay, I meant saying I'm going to try to find them. You get on my nerves. I'm so mad at you.
Okay.
Maurice, you see my mad face, Maurice?
Yeah, people rather message than talk. That is correct.
But I'm saying, but you message me on Facebook. But that's okay.
She was joking, Doran. She's not really mad.
What is that?
Minnie says she want it purple.
Oh, purple rain.
Purple.
So you print. Long as you promise not to talk on speakerphone while you do it.
Oh. Really? Cell phone police. There she go. Gonna get you a badge and a nightstick.
I would. I'd be good at that. We're looking around for some companies, Maurice. Yeah. We have
We're going to have different ones. We're going to have the baseball ones, just white with the color sleeves, V-necks, all that. Down.
What I was saying is send it to me because what I'm going to do is put the different ones we get. Because the ones we have, the real logo is black and red. And so we tried this with one color because we can wear it on different shirts. Because all the other shirts we have are like a gray. So, yeah. You know.
We got hats and stuff too, all that.
Oh, I do have a hat.
Umbrellas.
Inbox me.
Hey, get the jug too, baby. Give me the coffee cup.
The coffee cup?
Yeah, we should have been drinking out of our Black Love coffee cups. Yeah, we should have been sipping tea out of the Black Love coffee cups.
Oh, and a keychain.
Yeah, keychains, all that there.
Jesus, I didn't know we had so much stuff.
I know, right? Although we're going, and then we got to get the magnet too. We got refrigerator magnet.
Jesus, dude, no, I can't get it off.
Be strong.
No. All right. So this is a Black Love coffee cup.
Black Love.
It's gonna mess up my hair.
So you can sip your tea. Yeah.
Ooh, my hair too big. It's the hat.
And it also comes in with a black trim.
Look, Zia, look at the Velcro on my hair.
Don't do that, honey.
And we had something else. What you said? Oh, my keychain. Where my keychain at?
I don't know.
Oh, he didn't know.
She don't know where it is. I don't know where it is. It's stuff everywhere.
See my Black Love keychain, y'all? We Black Love for real.
For real, for real.
So inbox us if you would like something. And I guess we have to stop. Have to post it all. Yes, nobody's allowed to drink out of my Black Love teacup, my cup. Got our website on there. Yes, Kristen, and you miss it all, but go back and see it. Share it to your page. The backdrop is what you see at I can't read. Maurice, all that stuff is what we do for the Christmas gala. Like, we have functions where people can take pictures. If you look on our page, all the pictures that people took from the galas was with this backdrop. So
Minnie says she want a visor. We'll hook that up for you.
Minnie, long as you promise not to be on speakerphone. Okay, I'm sorry. All right, good night, y'all. I got to go to bed. The website is www.blacklovenited.com. Follow us on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, which my husband, the Snapchat is on his phone, but he don't have a Snapchat.
Yeah,
I Snapchat my personal, but he don't Snapchat.
I'm working on the snaps. I'm working
he
on it.
He said he's going to do better.
I'm going
to
try.
I want those Black Love wall magnets.
Wall stickers.
It would be good with.
Hey, inbox, man. We handle it.
Gotcha. Inbox us if you're interested. And as soon as I get everything out, I know to send it out, send it your way. But like our events on the page, we are out for tonight.
Black Love out.
What?
Black Love out.
Say that in English.
I said Black Love out. That was the little kid was saying the NBA this weekend. Jarius, what's his name?
Wristbands. Listen, we got so much Black Love stuff over here. I keep forgetting that we have it. We got a refrigerator magnet too, but I couldn't get it out the refrigerator, so he was talking about me just then. But
you gotta be strong, honey. Be strong.
All right, live long and prosper. I got big. What you say? I got a big what?
Big Ced. Yeah, inbox.